Wisdom is a principal thing. Therefore get wisdom. With all that getting, get understanding. But where shall wisdom be found? And where is the place of understanding? Man knoweth not the price thereof, neither is it found in the land of the living. This is the other school of destiny, where we are committed to build your hope and the dignity of wisdom and understanding for life pursuit and fulfillment in destiny. Listen and be blessed.
Good day, everyone. Student of Eliezer School of Destiny, how are you today? Let us pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for the school. Thank you for the student. Thank you for the teachers. Thank you for the words you are bringing to us to build us and change our lives forever. Father, I pray that our lives are changing. As we are assessing these things, I pray that our lives are changing all over the world. Our lives are changing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Amen in Jesus' name. Yeah, straight to business. This is BD 104. Purpose and Destiny 104. On the level series, Purpose and Destiny. And the topic of this one is I am inimitable. I am inimitable. The meaning of inimitable means I am unique. I am special. So I need you to know that you are unique, you are special. So we want to check the concept of uniqueness and strength. Okay, don't forget that we're talking about Purpose and Destiny in this series. And we need to check about your uniqueness and strength, how powerful it is, and how you can explore it. So, but before then, we need to explain a very good concept that it's not been understood by so many people over the world. Yeah. And it's a concept of work and job. A concept of work and job. Work and job. I need to let you know that the grossly unfortunate unemployment statistic that we have all over the nation of the world is because man refused to work. We are going for a job. It's too different. We need to know that. We refuse to work. Genesis chapter 1 verse 28, the Bible says, and God caused man, after God had created man, God gave man some set of instructions. He said, be fruitful, multiply. He said, dominate and replenish. The meaning of replenish means to supply, to renew, to renovate through innovation and creativity. And this can only be done with your work, not your job. Yeah? In the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 5, the Bible says, God did not cause it to rain upon the earth because there was no man to till the ground. Look at that. Can you see that? The meaning of till there means cultivating. Cultivate means to build. It's not a term used for agricultural science, you don't know. It means to build. That means the heart is a small child that needs to be taken care of. Renovate, renew, to build. So when we fail to build the heart, to cultivate the heart will fall sick. And the result of the sickness of the heart is what we have. This I'm explaining to you a spiritual mystery. It might not be applicable physically. The result of the sickness of the heart is the earthquakes, the tornadoes, all of these natural disasters we have all over the world today. And the economic disasters too. Talking about health, unemployment too. Because man refused to work. We're living our life 24/7, running after cash, running after dollars, running after naira, and any kind of currency. We just want the money to pay the bills. And man was not created to eat alone. Not to eat alone. We were created for a purpose. And that purpose is our work. What God wants you to be doing with your life. Inside it, there is money. Inside it, there is food. Inside it, there is everything you need to live your life. Not just to be seeking for a menial job up and down, just for survival. Do you understand what I'm saying? You see, today we have several people that has a particular career. So when they develop that particular career, they are distracted from what God asked them to, or what God wants them to do with their lives. Your career comes from your work, from your job, from what God wants you to do. Do you get? But you can develop your purpose in your career too. Yes. But when I explain to you the concept of work, you will understand these things very well. Okay, very good. Said, praise God forevermore. Hallelujah. Let me quickly explain the difference between job and work. A job is a work you do for living and survival alone, all for money. Do you get? And this is a letter to a frustrated life. This is why people are living there frustrated over the world. They will work, they will go to work from morning to night, for 40 years. After 40 years, they retired. After retirement, there's no retirement payment. And they will now start suffering at the end of their lives because they ignored what God created them to do. They use all their lives to seek for naira, to seek for dollars. Do you understand what I'm saying? But a work is the job of a man that reveals that man, and it produces more personal growth, satisfaction, rest, and eventually a lot of blessing, including money. You can find your purpose. Your work is your purpose. What you are doing to achieve that purpose that the Lord had given to you, the essence of your creation. Do you understand what I'm saying? So do you see the difference now? So God wants you to be a great worker, not a job seeker or job keeper. Nehem to 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. in the night, every day, every single day. Just to get money, to pay bills. The same thing your father did, to pay bills, he's retired now. Nothing out of his life. Refuse that kind of a life. Settle down. Discover what God wants you to do with your life. So as you are going to your job, you have in your mind what God wants you to do. As you are leaving the place of your work, you get back home, you get back to your work. Do you understand what I'm saying? Pass about work very quickly. God worked, you must work. Jesus worked, you must work. Fulfillment of purpose is a belief without work. There's nobody that can fulfill purpose without working. No potential will be utilized without working. A man was designed to work, not to run a job. Your work reveals your creativity and ability. Therefore, you produce. Man begins to die when he becomes lazy. Number 8, work gives you the space of becoming what you are. Number 9, to work is to utilize inner energy and capability. Number 10, you are responsible for all the potentials and abilities in you. Work to bring them out. Number 11, art becomes sick when man refuses to cultivate it through work. And this is the kind of heart we have today. Because people are not spending the 24 hours in God, in their God-given assignment and purpose. So the heart is sick. Because the heart is a young heart. The heart is a person. It's not a thing. The Bible said God created the heavens and the heart. It's a person. Like a small child. And it's sick now, convulsing, vomiting. We have all these disasters. Men designed it to be that. Men made art to be like this. We can make art a very suitable place for living. If only we can walk. Do you understand what I'm saying? So discover your work today. So that's about that. Number 2, I want to talk about the man and his product. I hope you have the manual with you. If you don't have the manual, try and get it, download it, or contact us on our social media platform. We'll get the manual to you. You get that. Eliezer's Call of Destiny. The man and his product. The man and his product, number 2. So here we'll then understanding being fruitful and multiplication called productivity and uniqueness. In the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 1, God said, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the heart and subdue it and dominate it. What is that fruitfulness? Fruitfulness is not limited to the fruit of the womb alone, talking about children. No, there are about 7 mysteries that I have found out personally about what fruitfulness is. The womb is one of them, by reproduction, reproducing. Do you get? Another one is the mind. The fruit of the mind is ideas and creativity. Number 3 is your hands. The fruit of your hands, you remember cultivating. That's your work. Number 4 is the mouth. The fruit of your mouth. The fruit of your mouth is your words. Words are powerful. They are the outstretch of a man. Words are powerful. They explain your ideology. They explain everything about you. Your words are your spiritual weapon to build up the life you wanted. Or your desire. That is it. Number five, the legs of a man, the fingers of a man. There is a difference between the hand of a man and the fingers of a man. David said, he taught my hands to war and my fingers to battle. You see the difference? So they are fruit of your fingers. Do you get? You win several battles before you win a war. A war is different from a battle. So that's about that. We'll take that more in some other series. And number seven, the fruit of your spirit. The fruit of your spirit is number one, soul winning. And the fruit of your spirit is number two, character. See, anytime you see motivation or fruitfulness in the scriptures, they mean the seven things. Do you understand? So every man, this is where we are going. Every man was born with a product. And I want you to understand that. Every man was born with a product. Man was created in God's image. And this image is greatness. It's the image of greatness and influence. So God wants every man to become great. God didn't want you to be small. But before you can become great, you must find your product. Every man has his own product, specially made for him. Do you get? Made with him. You must discover this product. Do you understand what I'm saying? You see, let me explain this simply. When God created man, God created just one man. Do you understand? And after that one man, called Adam, the first man, it took the 7.7 billion people all over the world that we have today. So that means a possibility of God was formed in that man and was being dispersed across. So that is the reason why we are not complete in ourselves. Do you understand what I'm saying? If you have the manner, I explain some things there. I won't record, but it's just a 15-minute record. Get the manner and read more about them. So, the things I can do, another person might not be able to do it. The things another person can do, I might not be able to do it. That was how God created us. God didn't create man for isolation. God created man for man. We were created to need each other. Do you understand? That's why the true religion is a religion of love. We were created to live with each other. So anybody that supports racism has no knowledge in them. Because every man were formed out of one man. One man called Adam is being dispersed into 7.7 billion people we have all over the world. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is the concept of product. And productivity. So my own product that God had created with me, it's my uniqueness. And that uniqueness that the Lord had created with me, are you getting me? Is a dimension of God that God wants to reveal to me, through me. Do you understand? So everybody has his or her own too. That's it. For example, let me give you one example now. In the gospel music, we have the likes of Don Wayne. They are singing song with music, gospel music. We have Don Wayne, we have Kirk Franklin, we have Kim Burrell, we have Natalie Bassi. Don Wayne is a songwriter, and he has a very simple technique in using and revealing revelations out of his songs musically. Look at Kirk Franklin. Kirk Franklin cannot really sing, but he can produce good songs that has deep musical content and good lyrics. He can write great songs. He wins Grammy Awards almost every year. Look at Natalie Bassi. Natalie Bassi is a man that sings good lyrics, but God had given him a spiritual sound to back up his voice. That's the trumpet that he blows, the shofar he blows every time he sings. Look at Kim Burrell. Kim Burrell cannot play trumpet. She sings normally, but she can run scales. Now imagine Don Wayne running scales. No, skills. Because that is their individual product. Imagine in the music, gospel musical, in the gospel music world, we had different people with different products, and each of them had found out their uniqueness, their product. Do you get? And they branded their product. And that is what made them special. That is why everybody's listening to them all over the world. Do you understand? Just imagine Kirk Franklin now wanting to be singing like Kim Burrell. What a disaster that would be.
Look at, for example, now, Bill Gates. Bill Gates and Mark Zuckerberg, they are both in the tech world. But Bill Gates, this month with operating system, Microsoft, Zuckerberg is dealing with social media, both in the tech world. Are you understanding the concept? So that is how God created man. So you must find your own uniqueness. Find your own uniqueness. What makes you special? And believe in it. How do you find this? Very quickly before I round up. You see, number one, you must understand and accept yourself. Find out yourself. The greatest disease that can happen to every man is to not find out themselves. You understand yourself and accept yourself like that. A lot of people want to be like every other person. It's an abuse to your personality, wanting to be like another person. I see a lot of singers wanting to copy another singer. I see a lot of preacher wanting to copy another preacher, wanting to be preaching like that. It's wrong. Be yourself. I'm not saying you shouldn't have role models. Have role models, model your life after them as you can have it, but don't want to be like them. Want to be like yourself. Find out that unique something about you and develop it. That is your power. That is your brand. Believe in it. Don't let anybody talk you out of it. That's your brand. That's your brand. And that is what people will buy. Okay, let me ask you one question. If you have a particular singer you love listening to, and there's another thing that wants to be sounding like that singer, and the two of them produce a song, who will you buy the song? Definitely the guy that knows how to do it. Because the other guy is struggling to become like this guy. And we have two products in the market. We have the perfect one and the other one that is wanting to be like the other one. That would definitely go for the perfect one. That's the reason why a lot of people will never come to limelight in life. Because they never find out their own product and their brand. God has given you a product. Find it out. Find it out. Sit down with yourself. Understand yourself. Understand your makeup. And put together everything the Lord has put into you and brand it. Let me give you the second way to find out your uniqueness and your product is through mentorship. Your mentor is authorized of God to discover your uniqueness. Anytime, if you have a good mentor, he must be able to know your strengths and your weaknesses. So your mentor will tell you, I think you are good at this thing. And you might not be able to see it yourself. So that's why it's very important for you to have a mentor. Have somebody that is mentoring you, coaching you. We talk about mentorship and coaching in this series too. Yes, we talk about it very well. That's what I'm saying. So don't forget, you are created uniquely. There is no like you in all over the universe. The proof of that is that your fingerprint, there's no two of it all over the world, your fingerprint. So God had created what is uniquely made. He has created it with you. To be able to bat a new thing in her. God wants us to cultivate this heart, renew it, replenish it, renovate it, take care of this young child called heart. Treat her from diseases and sicknesses so that we'll be able to live a beautiful life for ourselves. That is why God created us. So discover your work and start working on it. I'm not saying you should stop doing it for your job. You can still keep on it to get it to get the funds before you now resume back to your work. Do you understand what I'm saying? I hope you get this point. But let us pray. Father, we thank you for tonight. Thank you for the class. Thank you for the listeners all over the world. Thank you for your boy that you're using. Be this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that this word will be fruitful in their hearts. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Amen in Jesus' name. Thank you for joining me tonight. God bless you. Good night.
We believe you've been blessed by this teaching of wisdom. For more inquiries, contact us on Facebook and other social media platforms as Eliezer School of Destiny. God bless you. Amen.